Welcome to your Let's Talk. I'm your host, Swapnil Bhartia, and my next guest is F. Kontsevoy, CEO and co-founder at Teleport. F, it's great to have you on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Since this is the first time we are talking, I would love for you to explain what is the company all about, because you are also a co-founder. So talk about the problem you saw in the space that you created the company.
We are Teleport. We say that we're an access plane company. So access plane is our product. So access plane provides engineers with secure remote access to their cloud computing environments. Things like servers, Kubernetes clusters, internal web applications, databases, so on and so forth. Because we're not, as engineers, we're not physically located in data centers, which means that everything we use to do cloud computing is operated remotely. So Teleport is the best way to do it.
Why you created the company? What problem that you saw in that space that you're like, hey, no, we need to solve this problem?
Access is extremely complicated problem that, and the pain is only getting worse. So if I were to dive into like, what is access? What is remote access? Well, that's secure connectivity, authentication, authorization, and audit visibility into what's happening. So, and those four things are incredibly complicated and painful these days because we get more and more computing resources. The clouds are growing. Then you get more and more software deployed in there. So you have things like multiple databases, and you have servers with SSH and RDP. And then you have Kubernetes clusters, and you have internal applications like Grafana dashboards, for example. And all of those things need secure connectivity, authentication, authorization, and audit. So configuring every single computing resource with proper access takes a lot of time and energy, but also a lot of companies just don't have the talent, or maybe they have engineers who are just working on other issues. In other words, it's just a huge operational overhead to maintain those four pillars of access across your entire computing footprint. And that's what we do. We say Teleport is an access plane. So we consolidate access in one place where we allow you to configure everything just one time, and then you get amazing user experience and amazing security and compliance.
If we just go back to the kind of infrastructure we are building today, we talk about hybrid cloud. We have a lot of things on-prem, we have a lot of things on public cloud, and then we also have multi-cloud where we are leveraging, you know, different clouds. How challenging it becomes, because authentication can become a challenge, because every cloud providers, they have their own identity management solution as well. So talk about, you know, when we do look at this, the multi-cloud world, what kind of unique challenges that you see there?
So the access right now is siloed. Even when you say that access, cloud providers have their own access solutions, but they only take care of their own stuff. Like if you look at AWS, yes, they have access, but that's access to their own APIs. That's access to resources they provision. But if you install MongoDB on your AWS infrastructure, AWS is not really helping you access it. Like that's on your own. You need to configure MongoDB. You need to somehow securely expose it so your engineers can establish secure connectivity. You need to connect it to your identity platform, right? Like, is it Active Directory or Google Apps? So you have to configure the audit to go into one central place. So you see all of this work, the silo pain starts becoming apparent very early, but then you end up with multiple AWS accounts, and then you start using other clouds. And then maybe you have your own data centers that you also need to access. So it gets worse and worse and worse. And frankly, the difference between, is it on-prem? Is it cloud? Is it edge? All of this is merging right now. So if you, there are plenty of companies, like I could think of someone like Tesla or any of these autonomous driving vehicles. How are they operating? Like, what are they deploying into? They're basically deploying code into a planet Earth, because that's really your deployment target. And if you're doing that, so then of course, the access needs to be consolidated. So in one place, like that's why we call it access plane, similar to data plane or control plane, you will have your connectivity, authentication, authorization, and audit.
If you look at just like last 18 months, because of this pandemic, even if we don't see the companies' approach towards digital transformation or embracing cloud change, but it did get accelerated. Did you see any spike in either demand or, you know, as people rush toward cloud? Initially, it was just rush, and then the hangover period is over. Now they are dealing with the real problems, and that's where your four pillars come into picture. What have you seen in the last 18 months? Any you know, where you see, no, that was a natural trajectory that was already happening, or you did see some spike in demand or traffic?
I would say this, it's both. As I said, the major three pain points of implementing Access properly are, as I said, hardware, software, peopleware. So if you look in the hardware side, the infrastructure footprint has been growing. Like, you would be meeting with a company with, I don't know, 50 employees, and they might already have thousands of servers. So that's the hardware pain. We just get more infrastructure. On the software side, you get more components that go into every computing environment. You know, things like containers and Kubernetes and dashboards and cache and whatever. So each environment is more complicated. And the pain point that you are bringing up is the peopleware problem. So now we have more engineers than ever. It's becoming more and more popular profession. And engineers are increasingly commonly working from home, which means that they can borrow the significant other's iPad, for example, to do production deployment, right? So that trend has also been undergoing, and pandemic only accelerated it. So yes, we have seen the trend towards accelerating of adopting better access solutions in the industry, as well as COVID-induced kind of surge of interest.
Excellent. Now, I want to switch the topic and bring it back to the company and teleport. If I'm not wrong, you folks recently updated teleport and offering, you know, support for MongoDB. Tell me what's new there with teleport.
If you think of teleport as a mechanism how you get access to your infrastructure. So there is obviously two kind of dimensions for how we can be evolving as a product. On one dimension, we are adding support for more and more computing resources. In other words, things that you have in your computing environments. And with this version 7.0, we added support for MongoDB. Previously, Teleport had support for SSH, for Kubernetes, for MySQL, for Postgres, now MongoDB. That's one dimension. And the second dimension that we think about evolving the product is adding support for more and more client types, right? So you could use Teleport programmatically, you could use it like manually. We are thinking about expanding to like data analysts, right? Because they don't always use command line. Sometimes they use graphical GUIs. So they need a graphical way to connect to all of the databases in the world. So that's the way we think about growing. And that is the major new addition to Teleport 7.0, MongoDB.
Can you also talk about how are you involved with open source? Do you consume open source? Do you contribute to open source? Tell us your open source story.
Open source is how internet works. Without open source, we probably would have been like 10 years behind in terms of overall progress in the industry. So we are an open source company. Everything we do is open source. And we're also standing on the shoulders of giants, like other companies, other contributors who built amazing open source tools and technologies. For example, we often get asked this question, like, did you guys build your own crypto? The answer is, of course not. Teleport is built, again, as I said, standing on the shoulders of giants, on Google's implementation of all SSH crypto, for example, for SSH protocol, which is part of like a broader Golang ecosystem, where Golang itself is open source. So that's the kind of company we are. So if you're listening and you're an engineer and you like security and you like Go, reach out, because we're hiring for every single position imaginable. So yeah, we think of ourselves as an important part of open source community. The open source edition of Teleport is just as secure as what we sell to enterprise. So we don't make any compromises on the security side. the things that we charge money for, they usually related to scale. You know, like larger companies, they care about things like highly granular access control or integrating with enterprise single sign-on or enterprise solutions like Splunk. So that's our enterprise offering. But if you're a smaller team and you're fine with Google Apps or GitHub as your source of identity, then Teleport is a fantastic free and open source tool to get access to your clouds.
Excellent. So if I'm not wrong, the way I look at it is that you have an open source project, but you also offer commercial support around it. Because with open source, open source solves day one problem. You can easily grab the code, get it installed. But what about update? What about maintenance? What about new features that you may need? And then you mentioned, you know, scalability. So that I see as a typical open source story where people can use open source code base, they can play with it. But there is also a vendor where they can go to if they need to scale.
Absolutely, yes. Because what is product? Product is our expertise packaged in the form of a file that you download. And if you need more of it, then what you pay money for, and then you could get an enterprise contract and relationship with the vendor with us.
Excellent. We just talked about the updates related to 7.0 release. Of course, you cannot share a lot at this point. There'll be other news announcement. But if you can share the kind of roadmap that you have or things that are in the pipeline that you can share.
So first of all, our roadmap is public. That's another advantage of dealing with open source companies, is because we develop in the open. So anyone can go to GitHub. You could just probably type like GitHub Teleport SSH and you will find repository, and you will click on, so you will see all the tickets where community is asking us to build certain features. And simply reading comments on these tickets, you will see what the core open source contributors think about this or that idea. And then if you click in documentation actually has a section on the roadmap where roadmap is published. So we're working obviously on adding support for more database types. So Microsoft SQL Server is a plan. Support for Windows desktops and other forms of remote desktop access is also on the roadmap. So all of these things are public and you can go and see how they're being worked on. We even publish what we call kind of design documents. So just so community will see how it will be implemented. And hopefully provide feedback and also learn, because we have some pretty amazing security people working on Teleport.
Yep. Thank you so much for taking time out today and talk about not only Teleport, access control, and all those four pillars that you explained, and also how you are helping companies, irrespective of where their workloads are running, what kind of cloud they're running, so they can manage them. Thanks for those insights, and I would love to have you back on the show. Thank you.
Thank you. It was a pleasure to be here.